The fourth process is isochoric process. Isochoric means here the constant volume. The volume is constant here. Now you can see here diagram. In a diagram, gas is heated at constant volume. So volume is not changing. But you can see here, this, if volume is constant and we are heating the gas, it means that obviously the pressure start increasing. As temperature increases, pressure increases. In this isochoric process, system does no work on environment during an isochoric process. So you can see here a graph. So volume is constant. So here, this is initial position, this is final position. This is initial pressure, this is the final pressure. By third law of thermodynamics, increase in internal energy is equal to Q. Because here, no work done. This means that for isochoric change, all the energy added in the form of heat remains in the system itself and cause an increase in internal energy. Thermodynamics of isochoric processes. For isochoric process, we have change in volume is equal to zero, and all the energy supplied to the system is converted into the internal energy. Because Q is equal to delta U that we already written here. The first law of thermodynamic for isochoric process is Q is equal to delta U. Heat supplied is used to increase the internal energy. The change in internal energy is given by, we have a formula of change in internal energy, N CV into delta T. CV is a specific heat at constant volume. The work done is given by, so work done is given by formula P into delta V. So work done is zero here because all the energy is utilized to increase the internal energy. So no work done in this case. Or you know that work done formula is P into delta V. So this no change in the volume. So no work done. So change in volume is zero. So work done is zero. Heat exchange is given by first law of thermodynamics, and you know that Q is equal to delta U plus W, but W is zero, so we can write Q is equal to delta U is equal to N CV delta T. So we get this is a 4Q. Now fifth thermodynamic process is adiabatic process. Now what is adiabatic? So adiabatic process means it is a process during which there is no transfer of heat from or to the system. No transfer of heat from the system or to the system. Now you can see here the cylinder is enclosed by insulating surrounding material. So this is the insulator. Now when we heat such type of gas, then energy is not transferred. Energy, no transfer of the heat from the system or to the system. And here you can see the relationship between a pressure and volume in adiabatic process. As this volume increases, pressure decreases. And the temperature also you can see. For adiabatic change, delta Q is equal to zero. Q is the heat. For adiabatic change, Q is equal to zero. So here we can write change in internal energy is equal to minus W. You know that change in internal energy is equal to Q minus W. So Q is zero. So here we can write delta U is equal to minus W. When system expand adiabatically, this work done is positive. So work done by system is positive. And delta U is a negative, the internal energy of the system decreases. We know that when volume increases, the work is positive. When volume decreases, the work done is negative. So that you can remember here. So when system is compressed adiabatically, W is negative. So you know that when it expands, W is positive. When it is compressed, W is negative. And delta U having opposite sign to the work done. If work done is positive, delta U is negative. And here work done is negative, so change in internal energy is positive. So internal energy of system increases in an adiabatic process. It is observed that for many systems, temperature increases when internal energy increases and decreases when internal energy is decreased. Now let me learn thermodynamics of adiabatic process. For adiabatic process, we have PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Gamma is the ratio of specific heat. Means Cp by Cv. Gamma is Cp upon Cv. An adiabatic system is thermally isolated from environment, so it cannot exchange heat with it. Therefore, the system undergo adiabatic change. Its temperature and internal energy both change. Change in internal energy we can write here. Change in internal energy is given by this formula, Cv into delta T. Next thermodynamic process is cyclic process. What is cyclic? So you can see here diagram. So it is a PV diagram for cyclic process. This is the A, initial, and this is the final state. So A to B, we reach to the final state, means initial to final by path 1. And we reach to again A, maybe by same path or maybe by different path. That is a cyclic process. The thermodynamic process that return to the system to its initial state is a cyclic. Means which return to its initial is a cyclic process. In this process, initial and final state is same. You can see here, this is initial state A and this final state is B. In cyclic process, total change in internal energy is zero. If total change in internal energy is zero, then by first law of thermodynamics, we can write Q is equal to W. Heat supplied is used to do the work only. Now, what is free expansion? These expansions are adiabatic expansions, and there is no exchange of heat between system and its environment. Also, if it is adiabatic expansion, so we can write there is no work done on system or by the system. So Q is equal to W and it is equal to zero. By first law of thermodynamics, we can write it is delta U is equal to zero, because delta U is equal to W that we have written in the first. Now, for example, so here example is given. When balloon is ruptured suddenly or tire is suddenly punctured, the air inside rushes out rapidly, but there is no displacement of piston or any other surface. So here the work done is zero. So this is an example of free expansion. Free expansion basically is an uncontrolled change. It is an instantaneous change and the system is not in thermodynamic equilibrium. So here it is not in equilibrium. Free expansion cannot be plotted on PV diagram. Only its initial and the final state can be plotted. We cannot plot a PV diagram for this free expansion because we don't know the in-between states. The next one is heat engine. So what is heat engine first? The heat engine is a device that transforms heat partially into work or mechanical energy in a cyclic process. So just we learn what is cyclic process. And heat engine is a device that transforms heat partially into work or mechanical energy. You can see a heat engine in a diagram. So this heat is utilized to do the work. So this is the heat. So this heat is used to move the piston. So some work is done by using that piston. So here, heat supplied is used to do the work, mechanical work. Heat engine receive heat from source, or that source also called as reservoir, and convert some part of it to a work. That heat is converted into the work. Remember that all heat absorbed is not converted into work by heat engine. Some heat is lost in the form of exhaust. Typical heat engine having following elements. Heat engine having following elements, and the first one is the working substance. Working substance means the material which perform mechanical work. For example, diesel, petrol, then maybe whatever the material which is used to perform the work, that is the working substance, maybe a coal, etc. Second one is hot and cold reservoir. Hot and cold reservoir. So hot reservoir is a source of heat. So hot reservoir is a source of heat and it is called as source. So that heat is converted into the work. Cold reservoir absorbs large amount of heat from working substance at constant lower temperature and it is called as sink. Means heat engine having a two part, hot reservoir, cold reservoir. Hot reservoir is also called as source and cold reservoir is called as sink. These are the parts of engine. Then third one, cylinder. Generally, working substance is enclosed in a cylinder. For example, petrol, diesel, it is enclosed in a cylinder where it can be burned. Take a working substance enclosed in a cylinder, and that cylinder, cylinder with moving piston, moving frictionless, massless piston. The working substance does some work by displacing the piston in the cylinder. The displacement is transferred to some arrangement, such as crankshaft, and or such arrangement which rotate the wheel. The energy produced displacement of this piston is transferred to the arrangement where that arrangement is used to rotate the wheel of the vehicle. Now here heat engine are of two basic types. So just we learn heat engine, elements of the heat engine, then after that there are two basic types of the heat engine. The first one is external combustion engine. Now what is external combustion engine? External combustion means the working substance is externally, the combustion of the working substance is externally. So that is the external combustion engine. Heat needed for engine is produced by burning fuel outside the cylinder. And working substance is burned outside the cylinder. That is the external combustion engine. So here working substance is heated externally as in case of steam engine. You can see here the steam engine. So here the animation is there. You can see the animation here. So here the working substance is heated at part one. And then that heat is given to some other part and which is used to perform a work done, which is used to move the piston. So you can see here the phi is a piston. So this heat is given to a water. Here you can see here water, then it displaces piston and some work is done. And steam is produced, obviously. The heat is given to the water. Water produces steam, and that steam is utilized to move the piston. As the piston moves, some work is done. Next one is internal combustion engine. So this type of engine is used in two-wheeler, car, truck, etc. Internal combustion. In internal combustion engine, heat needed for engine is produced by burning fuel inside the cylinder. So here working substance is heated internally, similar to automobile engine using gasoline or diesel. Gasoline means petrol. You can see a diagram here. So this is a spark plug. Which introduces spark, and so this is a part from this. We are inserting working substance inside this cylinder, and this is the exhaust. So from this, whatever the gases are produced, which are going out, maybe carbon dioxide. Now we have to start with the working of heat engine, how the heat engine work, that we have to learn. So see here the parts of the heat engine. So this is a hot reservoir, cold reservoir. So you can say it's source. So this part you can say here sink. Okay. Now here, any heat engine work in the following three basic steps. The first step we discuss. Working substance absorb heat from hot reservoir at high temperature. So you remember here, working substance absorb heat from hot reservoir at high temperature. Second part, the part of the heat absorbed by working substance is converted into the work. I told you here, whatever the heat absorb, all the heat is not utilized to do the work. Some heat is lost in the surrounding. Okay. So part of the heat is used to do the work. And the third one, remaining heat is transferred to the cold reservoir. So here it is not lost to the surrounding, it is transferred to the cold reservoir. The remaining part of the heat is transferred to the cold reservoir, means transferred to the sink. See here, heat is absorbed from source. Then some is used to do the work and some is absorbed by this cold reservoir. So you can see here, this is the energy flow diagram. So this diagram is the energy flow diagram. So here we consider here the temperature of hot reservoir is TH, is the temperature of hot reservoir. Temperature of the cold reservoir is TC. Okay. Or in another word, we can say here, so heat at hot reservoir is QH. Okay, and that QH is used to do the work. Okay, means some part of the heat is used to do the work W, and other part is absorbed by QC, is absorbed by this cold reservoir. So let me define here QH, heat absorbed by working substance. QC, heat rejected. Cold reservoir absorb the heat and that heat is rejected. So heat rejected, and here QC is negative. So heat absorbed, QH, from the hot reservoir, it is positive. So work done by the working substance is W. So here by conservation of energy, we can write QH is equal to W plus QC. So here this heat QH, in this one, QH, it is equal to what? W plus QC, because some part is used to do the work, and some part is rejected by reservoir. It absorbed by the reservoir and then it is rejected. Okay. So here we, by conservation of energy, we can write QH is equal to W plus QC. So here W is equal to, the work done is given by formula, QH minus QC. QH is the heat from hot reservoir and QC is heat rejected by the sink or by the cold reservoir. Ideally, heat engine to convert all the heat absorbed QH into work, but practically not possible. So here, ideally, we can say that heat, all the heat is converted into the work, but here it is not possible. Some part of the heat is rejected here. It is lost in space. The thermal efficiency of heat engine is defined as, now let me define the efficiency. Efficiency means ability to do the work. So efficiency is defined as ratio of work done by working substance and amount of heat absorbed by it. So work done to the heat absorbed is the efficiency. Means here work done is what? Output. And heat absorbed means it is, means simply we can write the formula of the efficiency. Work done divided by heat absorbed. So this is the formula of efficiency. We can substitute here the values. So work done is W. Heat absorbed is QH. So here we get the formula here. W is QH minus QC divided by QH. This is the formula of efficiency. Or you can write efficiency is equal to 1 minus QC by QH. So this is the formula. Or you can write in term of temperature also. Or efficiency is equal to 1 minus TC divided by TH. So this is the formula of efficiency. Temperature of the cold reservoir divided by temperature of hot reservoir. This term. And this 1 minus of this ratio of temperatures. This thermal efficiency has no unit, that you remember. The maximum value of the thermal efficiency is 1. But it is not possible for any engine. Ideally, we can say that it is 1. So this efficiency is always less than 1, or in percentage less than 100%.